Now, just in case you missed it, don't forget that we're cubing the r on the bottom. Now let's do our integration. H is going to be a surface integral in this case. Plug everything in, so it's going to have jx, yp, minus ys, dxs, dys, divided by 4 pi xs squared plus yp minus ys squared, square rooted, cubed. And it's going to be in the z direction. The z does not actually become part of the integral. It's just telling us the direction that the magnetic field that we get from the integral is going to be in. Now let's go back and look at our picture. The thing that we're integrating is this area right here. It goes from xs equals 1 to 3, and it goes from ys equals 2 to 3. So let's put those in for our limits of integration. Xs goes from 1 to 3, and ys goes from 2 to 3. Now you're ready to do your integration. Let's see what parts you're going to integrate and what parts you're going to consider to be constant. When we're integrating the dxs term, here's the only part, the only variable that is actually being integrated. The rest of these are being treated as constants. Then when we get to the second part of the integral where we're doing dys, here are the two variables of integration and the rest are assumed to be constant. Yp is constant in these cases. So this is how we do a surface current integral, very similar to the line current integral that you saw previously. Now, what do you suppose happens?